folks. Dave here, the man from the East. I am, I'm not sure what I'm going to call this video yet. I am going to throw somebody under the bus really bad in this video. It's gonna end up causing a little bit of a stir, but it's gonna be done. I think the thing is, I've been in this community for a while now, and I've watched the reactions of a lot of the people who make comments. There are people who have video vlogs out there that they put out. A lot of smart people. I'll give them credit. But some people have to be called out. Sometimes it just happens. What I've seen in this community, the so-called Fenn community, lately, since I've been in, is you have all different types of people. You have really good-hearted people out there, and you have people that want to learn what Forrest Fenn's actual true salt is. And you have a certain few that I call, I'm not even going to bring that up yet. I'm going to save that for a couple of minutes later. You have all different types of people. You have the good people. You have the people that are just wondering what's going on. You have the people who have their solves and they don't want to let it go, which is fine. That's their prerogative. Most of the people in this community are wondering what happened at the end of Forrest Fenn's treasure hunt. Well, I'm at the end of this video, or towards the end, when I throw somebody under the bus, I'm starting to lean towards that might have been the whole situation. And I will show you why. I'm not sure how many people out there in the Fenn community, or the searchers before the search ended, have knowledge of an androgynous person being the closest person to finding the treasure. Now, that being said, some of you may have seen my other videos and know who I'm talking about. They will be thrown under the bus. I have a feeling with what I've thought about and what I think the possibility of this ending is, somebody will be thrown way under the bus today. So what I wanted to let you know is there's all different types of people in this community. The good, there are bad, there are just regular people and people who want to learn. But there's also people that I call touch holes. Not sure if you're familiar. This will let you know that I am from the East, from Massachusetts, because touch hole in our area is a different terminology than what it you'll find in the dictionary. Look up the urban definition of a touch hole and learn what these type of people are. These type of people are the kind of people when somebody in the community starts to see some type of hope of what a solve is, and these touch holes will come along and criticize those people and put them down, and they will put down the actual solve. These touch holes are just the type of people that they want to ruin everything. They want to ruin what Forrest did, what Forrest accomplished in his 15 years. His solve was so complicated, yet so simple. And I put it out there. I have put out Forrest Fenn's solve, his solution to the treasure hunt. Whether you want to believe it or not, it doesn't matter. It does not matter. All these other people who think they have solves, you don't. It just take it as it is. This, like I said in my other videos, there's one person, and I am that guy. And I am done taking the crap from the touch holes that just won't let the solve come through. And they know who they are. I'm not going to name names. I will just throw the one person under the bus. But they do. They know who they are. They will take some of the people who have hope and are looking at a solve and ask questions and just knock them right down. Everybody in the community, they knock anybody down that has some type of hope that some type of solve will come out and people will understand it. Well, those people, they're the touchholes. Urban Dictionary, look it up. Okay? Anyways, and it's from Massachusetts, New York area. That's that terminology. So, man from the East, thank you. Anyways, what I wanted to touch on by the end of this video was an email that I received from Sasha Johnson. Okay? Sorry, Sasha, it's time. I have to do it. I've been thinking about it. It's bothered me more and more, but it's time. And I'll probably receive a phone call after this video comes out. But I want you people to understand this whole situation, why I'm doing this, okay? When I solved it in July of 2019, I got together some pictures, all right? I don't know the exact date. I could look back at my pictures and find out, but it was July. Sometime in August, I mailed, because I didn't want it on email, I mailed Forrest a picture of the actual treasure location. Okay, the cross that says Kent and Esther, the little saying that says, if you don't have the first clue nailed down, you might as well stay home and play canasta. That picture was in there. It was four pictures in one 8x10 with a little story. And I told him, the other picture was the surviving myself about the story of him walking down to the cemetery one block north of his house, which was exact same explanation from where the fire pit is, his second home in the wilderness. So, and the canopy of stars with the little one cross in that. That's why Forrest said it was under a canopy of stars in the lush vegetation. The picture of the cross and the lush vegetation, the canopy of stars with the one little cross. When Forrest believed the treasure chest had been found in June, he thought it was me. But Forrest did not keep it a secret. Now, the reason I know this, I sent Forrest that picture sometime in August. 4 days after I sent it, Forrest, Sasha Dent put out a video that said, Forrest gets mail. Okay? I don't know what number it was. I don't know if it was the first. It probably wasn't the first one. I don't know. But she said, Forrest gets mail. And about a half hour into the video, she announces that the treasure, someone has gotten really, really, really close to the treasure chest, or to finding it. Was it the same person who was closest last year who said he was all done searching? Now, I had done that. I had sent Forrest a message that I was done. There's only one way she would know that. There's only one way that she would know and nobody else would know that the closest person had an androgynous name. Now, think about that. Raise your hand if you knew in your search time all the way up until 2020 that the closest person had an androgynous name. Because I don't believe that information was let out, but I can show you in this little clip of the email that I got from Sasha Dent specifically stating the closest person was a female with an androgynous name who lived in Santa Fe. Now, how would she know that, right? Unless Forrest gave her some information. Now, in my solve that I sent Forrest, I had already figured out that the Kent and Esther joined together was an androgynous name. You take partly male, partly female. Now, some of you who haven't watched my other videos, you may not understand what I'm saying here, but the people who have will understand it. So, that lets me know that Forrest, right away, at least went to Sasha Dent, Sasha Johnson at the time, and told her that someone got really, that someone is like really close to getting the treasure chest. I didn't tell him I didn't get it. I didn't tell him I did get it. He didn't know, but he told somebody within 4 days. That's crazy. Forrest let somebody know within 4 days that I was, not me specifically, just someone is what he told her. Someone was close, really, 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 really close to the treasure. Now, did anybody else get that information? Probably not. Now, this leads me to believe, and you see the email that I got. It's been on the screen probably already. Now, that email, her getting inside information, right? Did you notice Sasha Dent is out of the whole community? She does not do any more videos. Whatever happened, she does. I've asked her to come forward because she's the one that can validate that there was a person who was the closest to finding the treasure chest. And it's because I sent Forrest a picture of the actual final resting place. The final resting place was Palisade Cell at the cross with Kent and Esther. Kent being Superman, Esther being Aunt Esther, the homely girl with the cross. Folks, this all works out. I've had people tell me, because all my clues work and they all fit together. And if your mind works in a way where you can take those pieces and puzzle pieces and put them all together and keep it in your head, how it all fits together, it is magic, folks. And I've said that right along. And now I'm gonna throw this person under the bus because of what I know and what I want to give you for information. So, as I said, I'll be expecting a phone call because I've already talked to Jason last year when I asked him to come forward and say it. But Sasha stayed out of the whole thing. So what it's telling me now that I've really been thinking about it, because I've been shitting on Shiloh because he's backing it. But what I think probably the whole scenario, Forrest Fenn let Sasha know that somebody was really, really close, right? Eventually, I think what happened was Forrest told Sasha where the final resting place was. Now, she's out of it, right? Jason's out of it, right? So, Forrest talked about ending the hunt sometime around, November or sometime around that, October? I don't know. You people that are out there know the dates of things that happened. I don't. I didn't follow it. I knew that it was supposed to stay between Forrest and I about the final resting place, like he said. Okay? Now, if you followed this so far, if Forrest told Sasha Dent that where the final resting place was, and he didn't know whether or not I got it, he shouldn't have said anything. Sasha, right, and Jason go over really close into Cimarron and dig it up, okay? He doesn't have a shoulder injury. He doesn't have a job he has to worry about losing his job after 19 years of service waiting for the 20th year. But they go dig it up. Now, Sasha and Jason have the treasure chest, okay? This might... With Forrest told Sasha, there was a guy that he thought got the treasure chest. Why wouldn't eventually he tell him, or he tell her that where the final resting spot was? Because why would Sasha know an androgynous name if that was inside information? That's the only reason I knew and I solved this puzzle. Because Sasha let out that information that she probably wasn't supposed to let out. And that email is my proof to show you folks. Sasha Dent knew, Sasha Johnson at the time, knew that the closest person, and that was a clue from Forrest, the androgynous name, partly male, partly female. Unless Sasha is from Santa Fe, right? Forrest was giving her information, so she had an idea of where to look, but hadn't figured it out yet. But he told her, until I sent that picture, he thought that it was her, and told her it's a woman from Santa Fe with an androgynous name. Sasha is an androgynous name. Any way you look at it, Sasha had information that she does not want to come forward and put Forrest's name back to good, because Forrest is getting shit on, and he shouldn't be. These people that think all this shit about Forrest and Forrest set this whole thing up, you are absolutely wrong. Forrest was in the dark about the whole thing. So this scenario that I'm giving you, Forrest knew that I found the final resting place, assuming that I dug it up, but I had my reasons I couldn't. And I kept everything quiet. I thought it was going to stay between me and Forrest. So he tells Sasha, somebody is like on top of where the treasure chest is. Sasha keeps working him. This is why all Forrest's emails are deleted. And probably Sasha Dent's are deleted also, because she deleted that video where she said about the person getting really, really, really close. That's gone. Other people may remember it. They may not. But anyways, Forrest finally tells her, hey, this is where the final resting place is. I don't know if the guy got it. They go dig it up. Sasha and Jason have the treasure chest now. They contact Shiloh, okay, because they know that Forrest said, hey, this is another guy is supposed to have found it. But now they can't go to Forrest and go, hey, we got the treasure chest. Well, how do you have it? When this guy is supposed to be the one who has it. Forrest knew that guy's got screwed over. And all of you know that there's something fishy at the end. Well, I'm giving you what is like a highly, highly possible scenario of what happened. So, they contact Shiloh. Now, Sasha and Shiloh and Jason are in cahoots about hiding this from Forrest, because they don't want to upset him. But Forrest wants to end the treasure hunt, and somehow it says no. Well, he sends an email out to Pam or Dal. I'm not sure. He might have sent it out to Preston. Whatever. I've asked for help from everybody, and they won't give it to me. So it's time to throw her under the bus. Sasha has the treasure chest. Okay? Just, you guys know the whole situation of something's messed up. Towards the end, they finally say, let's put a picture from where we found it. And if you look at my videos, you will see the treasure chest sitting on the ground was the same exact mulch, the same grass, everything from my pictures at Palisades Hill where the cross of Kent and Esther were. And I had my friends take pictures of that cross area, and there were dig marks because I left it completely full of mulch. That was where they screwed up. They dug it up and they booted. Okay, so my area was messed with after the cross was gone. There was a ring of rocks there. So they knew. Somebody knew. And you people can call bullshit on it, whatever. Sasha and Jason will call bullshit on it. But I've got pictures and dates of everything that lines up and how it was taken. Like, it was dug up. My area was messed with. That was supposed to be kept secret. So all these emails have disappeared. Forrest's will, after he knew that Jack came forward, and Jack didn't have shit to give him for a solve. And I can tell you that high and low, Jack has shit to give for a solve. Especially Wyoming. They're trying to change this whole thing for you people. And I just wish you would watch my videos and truly understand how these, as I said, there's touch holes in here, in this whole thing. And they've been trying to shut my solve down because it makes sense. It may be so far out because Forrest's mind was so complex and tricky. And he did. He messed with people. Left, right, and sideways. But when he said those quotes, two people can keep a secret if one of them is dead. If you join Ken and Esther together, those are the two people that can keep a secret. Because if one of them is dead, both of them is dead. The secret's going to be kept. And you folks, nobody has answers to why he said that, except for me. Nobody has answers to 100 things out there of T.S. Eliot. It all lines up. If you watch my videos, folks, the people that have not watched my videos, you will see a connection. And if you don't see a few connections, and maybe some of the other things are far out there, but they are connected. I had somebody tell me, crimson is not red. Okay? Stupid, right? It's because of a shade. Crimson. Courage wears a crimson coat. In my Superman solve, courage wears a crimson coat. Is that my war for me? One of the poems. Do you think he was going to change the whole poem just to fit? Okay, so he told me crimson is the wrong shade red for Superman's cape, because I just felt like courage wears a crimson cape fit how to describe Superman. And Forrest said he had sprinkled clues throughout the whole book. So I was told Forrest put maybe 1 to 3 hints in the book. Now, if I take sprinkles and put it on my ice cream, there's not 1 to 3 sprinkles on my ice cream. There's a whole bunch of different things. And I found those whole bunch of different things. And I bring them in my videos. Now, believe it or not, it's not going to matter. They've already sold the treasure chest. The credit is gone to Jack or somebody behind him, because nobody wants to listen to me. It doesn't matter anymore. My solve is it's actually Forrest's solve. And all of these people are shitting on it. And you people, because you speak up and say, wow, Dave, that makes sense, they shit on you. They're touch holes. Those people that are trying to knock you down from seeing what the truth is, they're touch holes. That's bottom line. That way I don't have a big bad word in here, I say. But anyways, those people, if they would just shut their mouth and let things happen and let people have an open mind, they are actually creating a Forrest Fenn community that is not fun to be in. Nobody wants to join together and figure this out. But I'm letting you know, I know 100%. I've offered $10,000 cash to anybody who can prove me wrong on my solve. Please, jump on it, because you can't. There is no solve out there that has as many things as mine does. Timeline, Sasha Dent saying that somebody was like on top of the treasure chest, pretty much. It has, when I found the blaze a month later, Forrest saying, it's right out there. And it came out in December. Other video guys are saying it came out in like March of 2018. It did not, because I know when I sent that to Forrest on November 1st in December, I'm like, oh my God, a month later, Forrest is announcing that he has a gut feeling that the treasure chest is going to be found. That's because of my blaze that I found, that fire pit. If you folks think that it's someplace up in... And I've, like I said in the other one, people are guessing what Jack's solve is on 9 Mile Hole. You people, you should be pushing for the actual solve. And that's the only way that you're going to know the truth. And nobody will join together, and nobody wants to look at my videos and see all the hints. There are hundreds of hints sprinkled that Forrest put here. He didn't spend 15 years to do a 2-minute solve up in Wyoming that Jack has for you. Because Jack, he's a thief, and there's people behind him. And Shiloh, he agreed to say after Forrest passed away that Jack is the finder. Jack is not the finder. He's in front of somebody else. And I believe that it's a high possibility now that it's Sasha Dent and Jason. And they threw out that bullshit video because they knew that there's some kind of solve in a safe somewhere. And it was thrown out by Shiloh because it's all getting protected. Now, maybe a few people in the community that have done all this research and investigating. We'll look into this a little bit further. You may see some connections of Sasha Dent backing right out. And Toby Yunus, he's being useless as far as helping Forrest Fenn's legacy. And Forrest Fenn is getting shit on by so many people out there that they're saying he is behind taking the treasure chest back. He's not. He announced the man from the east. He was railroaded. And he was so upset. He knew. He put something in his will for the guy who really solved this. Okay? Now his Forrest Fenn's will's disappeared, right? Money buys you anything. And these people have money that they're hiding everything from us. The community. The people who want to know the truth. They are hiding everything. I get emails from Jack. And I put a few out. I've gotten more. Old Shiloh stopped messaging me because he knows he's not going to back me down. Because I know that I'm the one that solved this. And I wouldn't have my ugly face up on this video and all the other videos if I didn't know that 100%. And the people that know me, they know. I kid around, but I'm not a bullshitter. I will tell you the truth. And this solve is the true solve of Forrest Fenn's treasure hunt. It's bottom line. Now I've thrown Sasha under the bus. Jason, you're along with her because her name's Sasha Dent now. So the people that want to know information, start looking in that direction, okay? Because you might find there's a lot more information on that than you've been looking at or you've even thought of looking at. So Forrest Fenn did not keep it secret, folks. He let the cat out of the bag and told it right off. He told Sasha. Why? Within 4 days of me finding the final resting place, he told Sasha Dent, hey, this guy's on top of the treasure chest. Don't know if he's got it. This is where it was. Right? Think about it. I don't know who else Forrest told, but they eliminated his emails. But folks, use your head. Look at my solve. Think about everything that's in it. I'm telling you right now, there are people out there that see my solve as the number one solve. I've told people I can help them with dates on what and when things happen on my side of what the real solve was. And their information that they have of investigating, of other things that have happened. If you people don't want to get together and solve this, this is all just going to fade away. And pretty much, I feel like I put my life on the line at risk here. But I've already said in one of my other videos, if I get taken out, you guys know to go to look at towards Jack. And the people behind him have probably already talked about that. Hey, if we just eliminate this guy, he's just a small little, has a few followers. Let's take him out of the picture. But if I get taken out, all my family knows where to look on why I got taken out. So you folks, I wish you just watch my videos with an open mind and understand that this is the real solve, folks. There is no other solve that is out there that Forrest knew about. Hundreds of sprinkles from the first book, from the second book, and mostly from the third book, bringing in the superheroes for Superman. It is beautifully crafted, and it's so brilliant that I want you folks to understand it just for Forrest's legacy, just so Forrest's name's not smeared in the mud, because so many of you think that there was never a chest out there. There was. Okay? And I really wish you people would watch the videos with an open mind or with someone that has more of an open mind, because you're stuck on your own solve. Folks, you could have all the answers and know what it really is. And the people that haven't watched my other videos, going in this blind, use your own judgment. Okay, and I've asked, watch some of the other videos of some people's solves, but you're not going to have every single thing that's been answered. Why? Even simple things like Why bring a flashlight in a sandwich? A flashlight? In my solve, you have to go in at night to take the treasure chest because you don't want to be getting caught digging right next to the road, right next to the parking lot. It may sound like the craziest thing, but that's the way Forrest was. This solve was going to be crazy, and he's going to put it out so it all pulls together. So that flashlight is going in at night. The sandwich is because you're in the parking lot right next to Palisades Cell picnic area. That's why he says bring a sandwich and a flashlight. There's so many different clues that I can bring into this, and all the touch holes out there will just shit on it. They will shit on that. Tell me what I did wrong with that one, what a flashlight and a sandwich is. Because everything that I've said and I've given to you makes sense. Somehow, some way, it all connects together. And if your brain works in a peculiar way like mine does, you will see it. And there are people that get shit on out there that have seen it. And I feel bad for those people because they want to stand up, but they get peer pressure from the touch holes. So if you people are brave enough to step forward and say, hey, you know what? I've watched his videos. This guy's right. He's getting railroaded, just like Forrest did, to say, I will announce that the treasure was found in Wyoming. So let me ask you this. They take the treasure a month after they announced that it was found. They take it up to Wyoming to take some pictures. They leave it in their car and go and have lunch. Come back out. They double check it's there, right? Hey, they just found that the treasure chest is there. The treasure chest was found in Wyoming. Yes, after the fact. In the 10 years, Forrest said, people wonder, Forrest said it was it was where he put it for 10 years. He hit it 2009, 2010, right? So let's just say he hit it in 2009. 2019, when I sent him the pictures in July, that's 10 years, right? So Forrest said the treasure has not been moved from where I hit it 10 years ago. But it had been moved after that. Forrest gave us hints with everything that he said. And if you have questions about something he said, ask me. I will answer it with full... I'm happy to answer it. I'm happy to give the actual solve that Forrest had out to people. But these shitheads, touch holes, that just knock all of it down to make you people feel like losers trying to follow Forrest Fenn's actual solve. It's sad. Those people are sad, sad, sad people. And it's truly, truly hurtful and disgraceful to what Forrest did. I'm here. I haven't sued. I have full rights to probably sue. And I haven't. I've guided them to say, hey, just tell the right thing. I see, why must I go? You're actually doing the same thing. You're asking Jack to tell the truth. They're not going to. The only way they're going to tell the truth is when you confront them with the actual solve that is not in Wyoming. You need to get that through your head. And the other vloggers who have these solves, you need to really just... let go of it. Let go of the actual solve that you think it is, and join together with the true solve, because there is only one. And if you have as many hints and clues as I have, come forward. But I don't see it. I don't see it in anybody's solve. And I'm not here to criticize them. They worked hard on it. And I'm not trying to just shit on you. I'm just telling you, there's one solve. And everybody has to know. You have to realize there's just one solve that is out there that has every single thing. And I am the one that they are laughing at because you people are not seeing it. And it's a beautiful, absolutely amazing solve. Just watch it, folks. That's it. You people will watch this one video and I'll get... I know there's 20 or 30 touch holes out there, okay? And you touch holes know who you are. And then the other ones follow because of the peer pressure. Oh my God, this guy has 22 thumbs down and he has 2 thumbs up. I had 4 people tell me they gave me thumbs up, but I see 2 on it. It's it doesn't matter. I really, the thumbs up is just lets me know how many smart people are out there. Okay? Give me 50 or 500 thumbs down. But you know what? The millions of people that actually see the solve for how it truly is supposed to be seen will give me thumbs up eventually 10 years down the road when I've been taken out by the Sasha and the olds, because they don't want this information out there because it discredits everything that they've said, which is what? A broken blaze, Wyoming, 9 mile hole. Does anybody know more than that? No. There is so much information that could be given out by them, but Jack solved it. He's got this bias video that he did out there like last year. Did you notice Jack doesn't really put anything out to give you? Nobody, people ask him questions on his email, but he gives you nothing. He gives you a sidewinder answer that absolutely gives you nothing for information. And you people suck it up. You have to realize at some point, the smartness has to come through for people to realize there's one solve and it is out there. And they know that, but they can't just take me right out of the picture. I mean, they can. And then you know what? Then maybe you folks, then you'll be happy and you'll find out, hey, you know what? We should have listened to that guy. We could get all your answers right now. But I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to start my videos of my actual searches instead of, I've given you hundreds and hundreds of hints that pull this all together in all three books. And my last book, the third one, I did that quick. But there is some major, major hints that pull this together about Palisade, about 300 feet of Vietnam, Superman with the superheroes. And I didn't know that when I came up with the Superman solve. I had no idea about the superheroes in the third book. But you know what? Out of the couple of hundred people that have watched my videos and saw the Superman connection, not one of them came forward and said, hey, Dave, there's superheroes talked about in the third book. You know, nobody steps forward because of the touch holes that just try to shut them down and shut me down. Well, you know what? I got the letters F-O for those touch holes. That's what I've got. They can. And as far as who's hiding with Shiloh and probably maybe Sasha and Jason, they are going to get, it's going to come out where you're going to have, Jack, you're going to have to spill the beans on who's behind you. Because when the community finally smartens up and says, we ought to be listening to one person, because everybody's got their own thing. You're like a spider web of all kinds of unknown things. One person, folks, start following, start asking questions, start joining together. That's the only way you're going to find out the truth of who stole the treasure chest from the final resting place, which is Palisades Hill at Cimarron Canyon. And you people don't want to believe it, but the smarter people out there will. And there's a lot of smart people out there. And there's a lot of just, I'm not highly intelligent. I will say that right out. I'm a regular guy. But my mind works differently to see these clues pulled together. And that's how it was solved, folks. All the dates, all the times, everything's there. Just watch it. And use an open-minded judgment. Don't let the touch holes try to shut you down, because that's what they are. And I could start naming some names. Believe me, I want to, but I'm going to stay out of it. And maybe they'll stay out of it this time and just let you people like rise out of the shithole that we're in of nobody knowing anything. I'm going to end it because I'm going to have supper with my girlfriend. And I'm going to start my videos at my actual solve. And I'll probably have my girlfriend join me on so many amazing things during our trips. Saving trout, generator blowing up, water pouring in the bedroom in the camper. Feeling one night thinking that we were going to get hit by a train because we're probably 20 feet from a 60 mile an hour train in the middle of the night. There's so many different stories I've got that I'm going to give out to all the people out there that want to learn the actual adventure of the solver, the true solver of Forrest Fenn's treasure hunt, which is why Forrest said, and I know he got railroaded, he said, the man from the east solved it, and it was under a canopy of stars in the lush vegetation of the Rocky Mountains. And he said that he wanted to remain anonymous because they wanted to do it behind his back. But when they heard him say that, they had to come forward with something. And that's why they came up with this stupid solve up in Wyoming. And if you people want to keep falling for it, that's up to you. But you're never, ever, ever going to get any answers from Wyoming. So look at my solve constructively. Folks, I am Dave Woodard, the man from the East, Massachusetts, and I am the solver of Forrest Fenn's treasure hunt. And if you can't see that, ask somebody else to look at it for you. Folks, I want you to enjoy this. It's beautiful. It's beautifully crafted. Look at it. All right. Have a great night. Have a great day tomorrow. Have a great weekend. And I hope to hear from you. I'm sure I'll hear from a few people. Take care, folks. Thank you.